गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
ओके, आई होप यू ऑल आर रेडी फॉर द रिवीजन।
यस मैम।
यस मैम।
ओके, सो वील स्टार्ट विथ हिस्ट्री। व्हेन वाज बेस्टाइल स्टॉर्म्ड? ओके, All right. When did Louis XVI ascend the throne?
Mam,
1674.
Okay. He belonged to which line of kings?
Mam, Bourbon
family.
How old was he when he ascended the throne?
Mam, 16.
Mam, 20 years.
20 years.
20 years.
Okay.
Yes,
ma'am. And he was married to?
Marie Antoinette.
This is incomplete answer.
Austrian princess Marie Antoinette.
Right.
Austrian princess Marie Antoinette.
Okay, Austrian princess Marie Antoinette. Now, when he ascended the throne, why did he found the treasury empty?
Because long years of war.
Wait. Akash, let him say. Yes, bro. Long years of war
with the Great Britain had drained the financial resources of France.
Okay.
Ma'am, because of the cost.
That is one reason, Dhruv. Yes, Akash.
Ma'am, because of the cost of maintaining an extravagant court at the ground of Versailles drained the treasury of France.
Okay, that was also one reason. More. More.
Ma'am, France also helped American colonies, 13 American colonies against the war with Great Britain.
Okay. Alright. Alright. And so he found the treasury empty. What then he decided to do?
Ma'am, call the National Assembly and increase taxes.
Not National Assembly. What was the name of that body? Estates General, right? Okay, so he called together a body of Estates General to increase the taxes. In the old regime, France was divided into how many estates?
Three estates.
Okay. All right. Peasants made up about how much of the percentage of the population?
90%.
90%.
Okay. About how much percentage of land was owned by the church and the nobility?
60%.
Okay. All right, 60%. What was tithe?
Ma'am, tithe was a tax applied by the church.
This is incomplete answer. Yes, 1/10. That is what you have to mention. Alright? Understand all of you? Yes, you have to mention 1/10. 1/10 taken by the church and 1/10 of the agricultural produce. What was tile?
Okay.
Okay, fine. What was livre?
It was the currency of France during the
war. Unit currency of France.
Okay, what do you understand by subsistence crisis? Okay, one by one. Not like this. Yes, Atharv, tell.
Ma'am, when the basic means of livelihood of the people are endangered.
Okay, all right. What do you know about the emergence of the middle classes?
Ma'am, can I answer?
Answer.
Ma'am, the British men starting trading with the lower classes. Thus, some people in the lower classes began to gain some money, and thus they gain some knowledge about themselves and their and the people. Some people also became educated because of the money they got by trading their supplies.
All right. Otherwise, this answer properly you will get on page number 6 and page number 7 in your book. All right. The 18th
yes.
century witnessed the emergence of social groups termed as the middle classes. This is a very important question. You get questions on middle classes also. And these people have earned their wealth through expanding overseas trade and from the manufacture of goods such as the wool and the silk. Okay. All right. Role of philosophers in the French Revolution. What was the role of philosophers in the French Revolution? You know, in your book, three philosophers are mentioned. You need to mention, if a question like this is answered, you need to mention those three philosophers, their books, and what is in their books. All right?
Ma'am?
Yes. Akash?
Ma'am, can I tell of the John Locke?
Tell.
Ma'am, John Locke, ma'am, refuted in the spirit of the laws and in the doctrine of the divine and the absolute of the monarch.
So, the book, John Locke's book was?
Ma'am, in the spirit of the laws, he refuted the doctrine of the divine and the absolute of the monarch.
Beta, spirit of the law is not written by Locke. Name of the law book is? Yes. Name of law's book is? Yes, all right.
Yes,
the two treatises of the true treatises of government. All right. And in that he has sought to refute the absolute right of the monarch. Divine and the absolute right of the monarch or the king. Okay. Then second philosopher. Yes, Adya. Yes, Rousseau.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Wait,
ma'am.
Adya, yes. What
ma'am,
about...
He has written his viewpoints in his book, ma'am, The Social Contract.
Okay. And what
ma'am,
did he say?
He made forward the idea of formation of a government that is based on a social contract between people and their representatives.
Okay, fine. All right, then the third philosopher.
Ma'am, Montesquieu.
Okay.
Ma'am, he wrote the book, The Spirit of the Laws, where he said to divide the power of the government into three important organs, legislature, executive, and the judiciary.
All right. So,
yes,
you will write that. And then the last paragraph on page 7, that the ideas of these philosophers, they were discussed intensively in saloons and coffee houses, and it was spread among the people through books and newspapers, and they were read aloud in groups for those people who could not read and write. And so this you need to mention, the three philosophers, their works, and then how and where their ideas were discussed and got to the people.
Okay.
So that you need to mention.
Okay.
All right. How many representatives were there from the first and the second estate and the third estate also in the body called Estates General?
100.
Yes, come on. Someone with the correct answer. This is not correct. In the body of the Estates General?
Ma'am, 300.
Okay, 300 from?
Ma'am, the first and the second estate.
The first and the second estate. And how many from the third estate?
600.
Okay, right. 600. Who was Mirabeau?
Ma'am, Mirabeau was born in a noble family, but he wanted to do something for the third estate, and so he led the third estate in the National Assembly.
All right.
Ma'am, Mirabeau was the leader of the crowd assembled at Versailles.
All right.
And he gave power. About powerful speeches and motivation to the people present.
All right. And he was convinced that
They're convinced to do away with the right.
Yes, with the feudal system and the system of privileges based on birth. Okay. And so National Assembly was led by Mirabu, and who was the second person?
Abyssines.
Okay, Abyssines. Okay, what do you know about Abyssines? Who was Abyssines?
Ma'am, he wrote.
Ma'am, he was a priest.
Okay.
Who wrote
a pamphlet?
Pamphlet
called What is the third estate?
Oh,
what is the
third estate? Ma'am, he was a philosopher, important philosopher in the French Revolution.
Okay, all right. So, why is the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen a revolutionary document?
May I answer?
Yes, answer, Shitesh.
Because at that time the government and all the monarch, they were based on the feudal practices, and on the revolutionary document laid. To do away with all the feudal practices, so it was a shock for the government at that time.
Otherwise, if this answer is asked, you need to write from page number 11, the Constitution.
11, yes.
All right. It began with the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen. Why it was important? Because see, rights such as the right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, equality before law, they were established as natural and inalienable, means which you cannot take away from any man. That is, they belong to each human being by birth and could not be taken away. It was the duty of the state to protect each citizen's natural rights. So in this way, it was said to be a revolutionary document because it gave such rights to the people. Okay. What do you know about the active and passive citizens? Active and passive citizens.
From active citizens,
ma'am. Tell.
From active citizens are those citizens, ma'am, which had done ma'am labor work of 3 days and had gotten the labor wages of 3 days. They were considered as active citizens and were allowed to vote.
No, not those who have done labor wages. Those who have paid taxes equal to 3 days of a laborer's wage. Means how much wage a laborer earns in 3 days. Those people who have paid taxes equal to that or more. And
ma'am, also they were above 25 years.
Yes, 25 years of age and above, and only men.
Men, yes, ma'am.
All right.
And passive citizens, and women, and poor men.
All right. So all those who did not pay taxes and women. Okay.
Remaining men and women.
Okay.
Were called passive.
And people who owned property. So the property section only were allowed to vote.
Vote.
Oh.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. What do you know or describe the insurrection planned by the Jacobins in the summer of 1792? What do you know about the insurrection planned by the Jacobins?
Ma'am, can I answer?
Yes.
Ma'am, in the summer of 1792, the people of Paris were angered. By the short supply and high prices of food. Then they revolted against them by under the leading of Jacobins Club. All the men above the 21 years of age got the right to vote in that time.
But you have missed that what happened during the insurrection. Insurrection is a rebellion. All right. And so what they did on the morning of 10th August, they stormed by force. They went into the palace of the Tuileries and they killed the king's guard and took the king as hostage. All right. For several hours later on assembly, they voted that the whole royal family needs to be imprisoned. Then elections were held. And from then on, all men of 21 years and above, regardless whether they owned wealth or not, they got the right to vote. Okay.
Vote.
And after this, the newly elected assembly was called as the convention. So you need not to confuse here. After the Jacobins planned an insurrection, all right, the assembly was called as the convention. But later on, after the reign of terror or the rule of the Jacobins, it was called as the directory. Okay, what was the directory, by the way?
Ma'am, directory was a governing 5-member committee.
All right, an executive made up of 5 members. Okay, and all of you need to be careful with your words. Okay, again and again I'm telling you, please use terms from the book. Okay, which period is referred to as the reign of terror and why?
1793 to 1794.
Okay, it is referred to as a reign of terror, but why? Why? Okay, Nidhi, wait. Nidhi.
Ma'am, because Robespierre followed a policy of severe control.
Severe control?
And ma'am, strict rules.
So, okay, severe control and punishment. Then, this whole first paragraph, alright? You need to write, yes, on page number 16, the whole paragraph. That's all those you saw as enemies of his order, alright? Or of his government, means ex-nobles, clergy, members of other political parties, even members of his own political party. Alright? So yes, anyone who did not, anyone who did not agree with his methods, they were arrested, imprisoned, and then they were tried by a revolutionary tribunal. And if they were found guilty, then they were guillotined. Okay. So what was guillotine?
Ma'am, guillotine was a device consisting of 2 poles and a blade through which a person was beheaded.
Okay.
It was named after Dr. Guillotine, who invented it.
Okay, fine. And then, you know, the second paragraph here, if they ask you the reforms of the Robespierre government, alright, then you will write about it from the second paragraph, that they issued a laws on maximum ceiling, alright, and on wages and prices, and then that meat and bread were rationed, all were forced to eat the plain degelite bread, and no one was allowed to eat the white flour. So all that you need to write in that. Okay. What was the condition of women at the beginning of the 18th century in France? Condition of women.
Ma'am, the women worked for a living in the third estate. The wages for them were extremely low. They had no access to education.
Okay.
They usually looked after their family.
Okay, and this also, like you told, you gave me the points, but then I know in your own words, but then again, page number 18, the first paragraph, that they worked as seamstresses or laundresses, sold flowers, fruits and vegetables at the market, were employed as domestic servants. Most women did not have an access to education, alright, job training. Only daughters of noble or wealthier members of the state, they studied at a convent. And after that, their families arranged a marriage for them. Working women, they also had to take care of their families. That is to cook, fetch water, queue up for bread, and look after children. And their salaries or their wages were less than that of men. So that will be the answer to the condition of women in the 18th century. Then, what were the demands of women? Demands.
Ma'am, to enjoy the same...
Ma'am, to enjoy the same and equal political rights as men.
As much like to vote.
Okay, so page number 19. Same political rights as men. All right. Then demanded the right to vote.
Train job.
Okay.
Wanted to be elected assembly.
All right. Or not only the right to vote, but also the right to be voted for. All right. So the right to vote, to be elected to the assembly, and also to hold political office. So these three are main. Then you can add more to it, like education and job training and all that. Okay, then the next paragraph. What laws were brought out by the revolutionary government to improve the lives of women?
Schooling was made compulsory for all.
All right, so schooling was made compulsory. Okay.
Divorce was made legal. Father could no longer force them to marriage against their will.
All right. So fathers could no longer force them into marriage, and marriage was made into a contract.
Contract. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Women could not get jobs also.
And all right. When did women finally got the right to vote in France?
Ma'am, 1946.
Okay, which three continents were involved in the slave trade?
America, Africa, and Europe.
Okay, so can you tell me anything about this slave trade, how it worked? Yes, can anyone tell me how
ma'am,
it...
Ma'am, it was called the triangular slave trade.
Yes.
Ma'am, the slaves were sent from Europe to America.
Hmm. Europe to America?
No, not from Africa to Europe.
The merchants and traders, they were from Europe. They went from Europe to Africa.
From the plantation.
All right. Then they bought the slaves from there, branded and shackled them, set them on ships and set them sail for 3 months voyage across the Pacific, Atlantic, across the Atlantic to the Caribbean. That is near America, all right. And then there they were given sold to the plantation owners. So triangle how? Because from Europe, Africa, and then America, all right. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Yes,
okay. So convention. It abolished or it freed all slaves in which year?
From 1794.
But it was again brought back in which year?
1804.
All right, when Napoleon, he ascended the throne.
Napoleon.
Hmm.
Napoleon.
And slavery was finally abolished in French colonies.
1848.
Okay, so what do you know about Napoleon Bonaparte and the reforms that he brought about?
Ma'am, he was a
ma'am. Ma'am, he was crowned as the emperor in the year 1804.
Hmm.
Ma'am, he was called the modernizer of Europe.
Hmm.
As he brought many changes and many changes, ma'am, like protection of private property, a uniform system of weight and measurement were introduced.
Hmm.
And the main thing that was introduced was decimal system.
Okay.
Ma'am, he also conquered many European countries.
Hmm.
He was defeated at the Battle of Waterloo in 1815. But his actions had a deep impact on the society. And he bought the idea of liberty and democratic rights.
He did not. But then the ideas of liberty and democratic rights, they were the most important. This is the conclusion, the important legacy of the French Revolution. So you will write that he was crowned Emperor of France in 1804. Then he conquered the neighboring countries and removed their dynasties which were ruling there. And he made kingdoms and set the people of his own families as rulers over there. Then he thought that he was the modernizer of Europe, introduced many systems such as the protection of the private property, uniform systems of weights and measures, and also the decimal system. And in the beginning, people saw him as a liberator, a person who brings in freedom. But soon his armies were viewed as invading forces. All right, people who come in with force where they are not welcomed. And finally, he was defeated at the Battle of Waterloo. Okay. So,
ma'am, is that just over?
Yes, beta, because it's time now. So, let's see. If we'll get classes next week also, then I will not take a class on Saturday. Okay? But otherwise, if we are not having any classes next week, then I will have a class. I will take your class on Saturday also, just to do civics revision once again. All right?
Ma'am, Musa, ma'am, aap join kar raha.
Yes, Musa. Are you able to hear me? Okay.
I'm leave kar
diya. Huh, it's okay, my dear. All right, so this will be all for today, and all of you learn and prepare well for your exams. In case you have any difficulty, any confusion, please ask. Okay?
Okay,
yes, ma'am.
All right, so bye, God bless you all.